The Philippines considers asking its allies to help deter China's harassment of its resupply missions in the West Philippine Sea. Meanwhile, the Philippine Defense Chief cautions Filipino influencers against advancing China's interests through disinformation. Katrina Domingo has tonight's top story.
The Philippine government is studying new strategies for future resupply missions for the BRP Sierra Madre at Ayungin Shoal. This follows the collision between a China Coast Guard ship and the vessel contracted by the Armed Forces of the Philippines for the resupply mission last Sunday. AFP Chief of Staff General Romeo Bronner Jr. says they are considering using a Philippine Navy ship for the mission, as Navy vessels are more equipped for such operations. Additionally, they are exploring the possibility of a joint resupply mission with other nations, similar to previous joint sea patrols with the U.S., Canada, and Japan. Bronner called upon neighboring countries to support the Philippines in this matter.
We are one of the most experienced armed forces around the world. We have been fighting several wars up to today. We have been involved in wars or conflicts. So kaya po tayo, yung mga sundalong Pilipino, ay isa sa mga pinakadalubhasa na mga sundalo sa buong mundo. Some of the our partners and allies, the more developed armed forces, they come to us to train with us.
He adds the Philippines will also uphold its responsibility in repairing the BRP Sierra Madre, the warship that is considered as the Philippines' lone outpost in the Ayungin Shoal.
But we have the right to repair the ship. No, because that is a commissioned Philippine Navy ship. China has no right to tell us not to repair that, while they themselves have created these artificial islands. Hindi naman tayo nakialam, hindi naman natin sinabi, don't do that. Hindi naman natin sinabi na don't bring in missile systems into these artificial islands. Sila ang nakikialam pa doon, no?
The AFP is also closely monitoring certain vloggers who allegedly disseminate misinformation and support China. Meanwhile, Defense Secretary Gilbert Yodoro says they are addressing Beijing's disinformation campaign on several fronts.
It's a three-front thing. There's a legal part which Solicitor General and the DOJ study, may diplomatic part. Sa ngayon, merong discussions on the code of conduct sa Beijing yata at inaasahan natin na mag-deliver ang ating representative doon ng posisyon ng Republika ng Pilipinas. Nag-iting po namin ang aming sovereignty operation sa West Philippine Sea sa atin po at sa ating mga kaalyado.
Earlier this week, several Chinese spokespersons accused the Philippines of illegally operating in the West Philippine Sea and provoking the Chinese Coast Guard and militia vessels, a move Beijing says is masterminded by the United States.
Ito po'y nakaka-insulto sa Pilipino. It assumes that we have no ability to think for ourselves and to stand up for our own rights. And I think this is really looking down at us, and that really disgusts me. We are not alarmed. That is expected of China. Disinformation and information operations is in the playbook of China.
The secretary is confident that with China's behavior, the Philippines is set to gain more support from other countries that are pushing to uphold the international rules-based order. Speaking of support, several U.S. lawmakers condemn what they call Beijing's maritime intimidation in the South China Sea. In a statement, U.S. House Foreign Affairs Committee Ranking Member Gregory Meeks, Chairman Michael McCaul, along with two other lawmakers, said they unequivocally support the Philippines after the Chinese Coast Guard and maritime militia vessels intentionally hit Philippine Coast Guard ships. They add this incident is part of a larger pattern of the Chinese Coast Guard's provocative behavior in the South China Sea, where it actively intrudes in other states' exclusive economic zones. They also welcome the Biden administration's announcement to increase joint patrols with the Philippines and other partners in the South China Sea. Katrina Domingo, ABS-CBN News.